Hello, it's Jill here from GJ Beads. Today I'm going to show you how to make a very simple beaded bracelet on some flexible wire with a clasp to finish it off using crimps. Okay, the tools you're going to need is a pair of chain nose pliers. These are flat on the inside with no ridges. You'll need a pair of side cutters or flush cutters to cut the wire. And then the materials, you'll need about half a meter of 0.46 millimeter bead stringing wire. You'll need a lobster catch, that's about a 12 millimeter one, 6 millimeter split ring, that's like a baby key ring. It's two rings of wire, so it's more secure when you use it on the end of your bracelet. Two little 1.8 millimeter crimps, crimp tubes, some size 8 seed beads, which will be your spacers, like the white ones here, some 3 millimeter metal beads, and about 10, 11, or 12 6x4 millimeter Chinese rondelles, depending on the repeat of your pattern and what size wrist you're making. Mine's got 10 in it. So the first thing to do is to take your wire, and using the snips, is cut a piece that's about half a meter in length. That's about 12 inches. I always use a bead mat that's A4 paper size, and I actually just measure it across the long side of the bead mat, and I know that that's really good as a bracelet. Okay, I always like to test that my lobster clasp works, because sometimes you get one and the little trigger mechanism is faulty. So if you just use the little trigger and check that it opens and closes okay, and at the same time link that into your little split ring, I find it easier at the end. So take your Beadalon wire, thread on one crimp, and take the wire through the hole in your lobster catch. And you want to pull a little bit through, so I've probably got 5-7 centimeters of wire pulled through from the clasp, and then double it back and take the wire back through the crimp, and you want 1-2 centimeters pulled through, enough to pinch underneath your thumb. See how that's like underneath my thumb? So pinch that together up against the crimp, and you've got a really, really huge loop here on the lobster catch. So if you pull the long wire that you're going to thread your beads on, if you pull that all the way through and reduce the size of that loop, you need to keep a tiny loop there, because your clip will need what I call wriggle room. So as you're putting the bracelet on and off and you're moving and wearing it, that clip needs some room to wriggle around. So keep that pinched together with your thumb and your first finger, and then take your chain nose pliers and come in close on the crimp and give it a squish. So I'm going to squash it one-handed, and that takes up the slack, and then I alter my grip, put the whole of the pliers on, and then I use both hands and give it a really, really strong squeeze to make sure that it's secure. If you hold the clasp and pull against the long wire, just check that that's held. If it's not held and it slips through, have another go at squashing the crimp and keep squishing really hard until it stops the wire pulling through, because that's what is the secret part of you know, using the wire and the crimps. Okay, this little tail here will get tucked inside the first few beads. If you've got a lot of wire, you can trim it back. So I'm just going to trim it to about half its size. And then as I start threading the beads, I'm going to tuck that tail inside the first two or three beads. Okay, so this bracelet is a very, very simple pattern. If I unclip this one, you can see from the beginning what we're going to do. So you need to thread on 1 3-millimeter silver, 3 size 8 seed beads. Your wire is really flexible, but firm, so you don't need a needle. So you've got the 3 size 8s, another silver bead, and then your crystal and a silver bead, and just repeat the pattern. Or of course you know, can be as creative as you like and make up your own design. So if you're doing a different design, you could lay all the beads out on your bead mat before you start, so you've got a rough idea of how your design's going to take place. Maybe if you're using some different beads. Okay, I find using some silver spacer beads really sets the colour off and always makes your beadwork look much more expensive than it really is. But you'll notice in my style of beading, I always use silver beads as spacers. Okay, so it's coming on quite nicely now. You notice when you compare the colours of the beads, even under the lights here in the camera, these look more purpley and these more amethyst. And you may think that they don't go, but I quite like the contrast that they offer in the finished bracelet. But of course, choosing the beads is good fun, choosing the colours and getting excited about how your design's going to come together. So we're getting there now, just two or three more repeats. There we go. When I made the grey gunmetal one just now, I felt when I tried it on, it seemed a little bit big for my liking. So I'm going to try this one repeat shorter. Okay, so if you've made one already, what you can do is line one up against the other, and that'll give you some idea of sizing. Yeah, so that's just one repeat shorter. So you'll notice that I started with a silver bead and the purple set of size 8 seed beads, and I'm going to try and finish with the same repeat. So I finish with a silver bead. Sometimes the repeat of your bracelet, you may need to finish, you know, right on the large bead, or even just offer the silver one if you need to save a little bit on the length. But I'm going to try it like this. So check that you're happy with your pattern. Okay, and then the last thing you're going to do is thread on another crimp tube. Okay. And then take your wire all the way through the split ring that you've already got linked onto your lobster catch. Whoops. So through the split ring, and then take your wire back through the crimp tube, and the first 2, 3, 4, 5 beads, mine's popped out after the big crystal, but wherever it pops out, okay, and then pull all your wire through, taking up the slack. So keep checking that tail from the beginning is still tucked inside, because it's a little bit sneaky and sometimes it pops out. Have a final check that you're happy with your pattern. And again, pull this snug, but you need to leave a little loop there of the wire, not the split ring, but a little loop in the wire so it's got some wriggle room. Then come with your chain nose pliers again. Very carefully line up the nose of your chain nose pliers against the crimp so it's very exact, and give it a squish. If you squash one of the beads next to the crimp, you'll crack it and kill it. So again, do a one-handed squeeze to take up the slack, and then go for a two-handed squeeze to really make sure that crimp tube is held on. And then if you take your fingers out beyond the wire, so you're not touching the clasp section, so my fingers are out here on the bead part, and just pull it a little bit against the catch, and if it slips through, you just need to readjust your tension and have another go at squashing that crimp. But this one's held nicely. And then come in with your side cutters or your flush cutters. Use the back side of them, the flat side, rather than that open side, and come in right close against the bead and snip that off. And the tiny, tiny little tail that's left will just shoot back inside the bead. And there we go. That's how to make a very, very easy beginner's bracelet with a clasp. Thanks for watching.